Hi and welcome to this tutorial on how to rig a semi-trailer truck within 3D Studio Max with the help of CraftDirect Studio plugin. My name is Patrick Martin and I'm with Craft Animations. The workflow is similar in Maya as well, so if your preference is Maya, you can also follow this tutorial. So let's get started to rig this truck. And first off, we are going to open CraftDirect Studio UI and create a four-wheel extended. And the four-wheel extended is used to animate the tractor. And first off, what we want to do is move and scale this four-wheeler to be approximately a good size. We'll actually make that a little bit larger. And then what I tend to do is place this front wheel nearly in the center axle of the front of that truck that we want to animate. The next step is to align those wheels to the high poly model that we want to animate. So we start off with the front wheels, align those, and then I will scale. There we go. And the same thing applies to the rear wheels. Align those. Like so. And then scale them. Perfect. We need to make these high poly objects children of the low poly objects. And this is to make them follow those when we start to animate. Like so. Let's just see if those are attached. Great. And then the whole truck needs to be also made a child of the chassis. So now if we move the chassis or the whole four-wheeler, we can see that all those tools are moved. However, we also need to rig these two rear wheels. Tool we use for that is called extra wheel. And similar process, align and scale to be a good size for the wheel we want to animate, like so. And before I link or make the high poly object a child, I will actually do a clone and then place that on the other wheel, like so. So now we can make sure to align, otherwise it will also clone the high poly object. So that's why I did that before the making the high poly object children. And then take the suspension meshes and attach those to the four wheeler. So the extra wheel tools with its high poly objects will follow the four-wheeler. So there we go. And now next step is the trailer. And for this we will use a tool called trailer. And similar process. Just move and place it in the center. So in this case, or line it in the center of the wheels. Like so, and then scale it. And I tend to want to place the trailer's wheels somewhat center of the trailer we want to animate wheels. and then we place the trailer just above the wheel, and then we start to align the wheels to the correct high poly wheel. And then again, scale. Like so. And make the high poly objects children of the corresponding low poly object. And with the trailer, there's a hook mesh that needs to be placed where the pin is. So I will align that. Like so. And then connect it to the four-wheeler chassis so that the trailer also follows the four-wheeler like the extra wheels. And then we have the other four wheels that we, or well, eight wheels that we need to animate as well. And those we will also create extra wheels for. So in the same way as we did with the truck, I'll create one, scale it to this desired size. Like so, and then what I would do is clone, align, clone, align, clone, and align, like so. And again, put high poly objects as children of the low poly object. Like so. And we need to make sure that the suspension meshes are connected to the trailer's chassis in this case. And there we go. We now have the rig in place. Actually, I see I missed something, because when I remove the high poly object, I can see that the trailer is still there. So what that means is that we need to make sure that the trailer object is following the trailer body. So let's try it out again. We'll see what happens. Now you can see everything is removed. So this is a way of seeing if we have forgotten anything. But it's looking good. Okay, next thing we want to do is make sure that the four-wheeler is actually behaving somewhat like a truck. So what I like to do is start out with one of the profiles. So find the profile that is suitable. In this case, I will use the truck. And I know that the stiffness of the suspension is slightly too soft. So I will actually add 1,000 to that. So it moves better and more stiff. There we go. And the next thing we need to do is also make sure that the extra wheels is fixated. Otherwise they will turn with animation. So I will fixate those in here. Like the following. But if you do want, for instance, in some tractors, you have the rear wheels that actually turn as well. So in that case, you might want to not fixate them if that's the desired outcome. All right, so rig is done, configured nicely. Let's just try it out. And what we need to do is select the four-wheel extended and then look at the bindings. So in this case, I'm using an input device, but you can also use a spline and make the whole truck follow the spline instead. But in this case, I will use the input device of the keyboard to try it out. hit record, and along as we drive there are keyframes generated. You can see it looks just great. There we go, nice suspension going on here. Great. And if you want to drive on a train, you can do that as well. In general case, when you need to drive on a train, you need to make the gravity directional meshes, these red arrows that are basically on all the tools, you need to make those children of the ground that you want to drive on. So let's make sure that we get those gravity meshes that we need to select. And what we want to do is place those under the plane, the ground that we want to drive on, like so. Okay, let's hide the rig and then try this out. I'll go a little bit closer. Okay, there we go. And hit record. And we'll bump itself down. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions or so regarding this tutorial or our tools, you are free to comment on the video, and we will try to answer those as quickly as possible.